Hi everyone. Today we're going to talk about how to identify sphalerite in polish section. So here's some sphalerite with some pyrite inclusions in it. Sphalerite's usually this medium gray color. As you can see, as we rotate the stage, there's no change in color or brightness. So sphalerite is not bireflectant. You can also see with that the hardness is fairly hard. The pyrite is sitting just slightly above, but this is a pretty good polishing job, so it's not that clear, which is the recessive one. Now we can see here one of the characteristic things of sphalerite is we can see this glowing as we are in cross polars, and this is due to sphalerite's internal reflections. And it's kind of this eerie glow. It's sometimes not super clear, especially if it's fine grained. But in these large, coarse grained sphalerites, it's really clear. While it might be a bit tricky to see this, it's actually isotropic, so it's not anisotropic. So any changes you saw was mostly just from the light being shined on it and how it's affecting the internal reflections rather than anisotropy. So here again, we have another piece of sphalerite. Again, this medium gray color, and it's not showing any changes as we rotate in plain polarized light, so it's not bireflectant. And again, it's medium hardness, usually takes a pretty good polish. So we're not seeing a lot of difference between the sphalerite and the pyrite in terms of polishing. Again, we put it across polars, and we can see all these internal reflections. This is pretty distinctive of sphalerite. Again, we may not see these in fine grain specimens, but if it's large enough, then we can see internal reflections commonly. It's not changing during the rotation significantly, at least except for maybe a little bit of twinkling of the internal reflections. Therefore, it is isotropic or not anisotropic. All right, next we're going to switch to one that is a bit more inclusion rich, and we're a bit more zoomed in than on the last couple of slides. So this is still the kind of medium gray color is the sphalerite. We've got a bunch of inclusions here. Again, as we rotate the stage, we're not seeing any changes. So it's not bireflectant. And as we put it in cross polars, we will see how many internal reflections we see. So again, here we can see internal reflections. They're a little less distinct, and that's because of the number of inclusions as well as kind of the finer grain that this sphalerite is. Remember, it's in a higher magnification than in the last one, but they're still fairly clear, and we'd be able to diagnose this as internal reflections due to the sphalerite. And again, so in summary, sphalerite's usually medium gray. It is not bireflectant, and it's not anisotropic, or it's isotropic, and it has distinctive internal reflections.